Good morning, dear children. Welcome to English class. Let us pray. Dear God, in your hands I place my life, that every decision I make, there will be wisdom, intelligence, and prudence, that I may always do your will instead of mine. Amen. Dear students, today let us learn a new poem, Two Blossoms, written by Robert Herrick. Fair pledges of a fruitful tree, why do ye fall so fast? Your date is not so past, but you may stay yet here a while, to blush and gently smile, and go at last. The poet sees the lovely blossoms of a tree. He calls them the fair pledges of a fruitful tree. What does it mean, dear children, here? Fruitful tree. What is that? Fair pledges in the fruitful tree. The word pledges here means children who are promises of hope for the parents. The blossoms on a tree are indications of a rich crop of fruit. That is why they have been called fair pledges of a fruitful tree. He sees that the blossoms are falling fast. It fills the poet with sadness. He asks the blossoms, why are falling so fast? He says that the allotted days of their life haven't yet passed, so they need not hurry away so fast. He says that they have yet time to stay here for a while. They have yet time to bloom and smile. And when they have lived their full life, they can go away at last. The poet here seems to be conscious of the fact that flowers bloom but to fade away. But he doesn't want them to fall so soon. What? Were ye born to be an hour or half delight, and so to bid good night? It was pity nature brought ye forth, merely to show your worth, and last you quit. The poet is filled with shock and surprise to see how soon the blossoms of a tree fall and fade away. He wonders if the blossoms were born merely for an hour or half's delight and then to go away forever. He calls it a pity that nature brought them forth merely to show their beauty for a while and then lose them forever. Here the poet expresses his grief that such lovely things as blossoms have so short a life to live. But you are lovely leaves, where we may read how soon things have their end. ever so brave, and after they have shown their pride, like you a while, they glide into the grave. Here the poet compares the lovely blossoms of a tree to the leaves of a book. He says that in these leaves we can read how soon things have their end. The poet says, a tribute to the beauty of the blossoms by saying that no other thing can ever be as bright and colorful as the blossoms. But all things of beauty have the same fate. After they have shown their beauty for a while, they glide into the grave. Like the lovely blossoms of a tree, they fall and wither away forever. Thus the poet brings out the transience of all life on this earth. So dear children, through this poem, the poet invites us to live a meaningful life. The life which we have to live is very short. So let us live a life of love. Thank you, dear children, for listening patiently.